Hello, my strange and charmed ones, and welcome back to my channel for another video. Today, I wanted to talk to you guys about how to customize covers, dividers, and dashboards for your planner, no matter what planner it is that you use. So basically, ever since I did that DIY planner video for you guys last month where I showed you guys the planner that I use that's completely like a DIY arc bound system with my own inserts in it and custom like covers and dividers that I made for myself. Ever since I made you guys that video, I've been fielding a lot of questions and emails about how you guys can customize dashboards and dividers and covers as well. Because if you remember that video, I actually gave you guys a few freebies, like a few digital designs for covers and back covers and dividers for your own planner. And I had a lot of questions because the size that I gave you guys was like the half letter equivalent that I was using for my arc-bound planner. But many of you wanted to blow it up for your happy planner from Me and My Big Ideas, or you wanted to use it for Erin Condren, or even use it as like dividers for like a personal size file of acts. So unfortunately, you guys weren't sure how to do that. And so today I wanted to kind of talk you guys through how you guys can actually use this really awesome free resource online to help you take basically any graphic image and either customize it to the particular size that you need for your planner, whatever planner it is, Erin Condren, Mambi Happy Planner, if it's a File of Facts, a Kiki K, Franklin Covey, like whatever it is, you can use this great free tool online that actually will help you resize your images. And furthermore, something that I think is really awesome is a lot of people have questions about how to actually customize the covers by like adding their own name. I know that like the Erin Condren style planners popularize like putting your name and the year on the cover. And a lot of people want to be able to do that or create custom dashboards or even take images for dividers. Look who this is here, Mr. Starbuck. Bubba Mama's making a video. So like I was saying, or even dividers. So think about if you have like a great image and you want to put like some text on a divider to say like calendar, tasks, to do, meal planning, like you can actually break out your sections of your divider by kind of putting like a custom title or label on it. So I wanted to show you guys how you guys can do that because this is something I'm asked about a lot, and I do create a lot of different graphic things that you guys can actually do that, you know, and really, you know, customize it to fit your planner needs. So I wanted to show you guys how to do that today. And also, really exciting, before I begin and before I get into the whole screencast that I'm actually going to do to actually capture my screen and show you guys, walk you guys through how to use that free tool. The first thing I wanted to announce you guys is, I'm not sure if you guys follow me on Periscope. If you follow me on Periscope, you were very lucky and you got to see a behind the scenes and see a sneak preview of my upcoming fall and Halloween sticker sets. And well, I guess I should say my fall planner collection, which includes sticker sets, journaling cards, and some really awesome graphics that you guys can use to, again, customize into covers for your planner, no matter what size planner you've got, make them dividers, no matter what planner system you've got, as long as you can personalize things for your planner, like it's not like bound like a book, you can use this method and actually apply it to the items in this collection that I have coming out for fall and Halloween. So basically on that video on Tuesday, I showed you guys the preview and I told you guys as soon as I was done, I would release it. So I'm very pleased to announce that today I actually have released the fall and Halloween collections for like my whole fall seasonal set, I guess we could call this, right? So I've got awesome designs for fall and Halloween that you guys can use as stickers in your planner, journaling cards, and covers, dividers, whatever you guys want to use, dashboards, the sky is the limit. So I'm going to actually show you guys the actual graphics today, and I'm going to use them as examples to show you guys how that you can personalize your own covers and dividers using my graphics, okay? So let's go ahead and switch over to the screen share. Okay, so the first thing I want to show you guys are the graphics for the fall collection that I'm calling Let's Fall in Love. So this is my seasonal fall collection of graphics that are going to be available as covers, as graphic cover images, which is what I'm going to show you right now. And I'll also go ahead and show you guys that I also have journaling cards and printable sticker sets. And of course, all of these that I'm showing you are printables in my shop. So when you buy these from my shop, these designs, you actually buy the digital file and then you're able to print them however you want. And you are also able to, if you'd like to follow the tutorial that I'm going to show you guys next, you can actually customize these into whatever sort of size you need for your planner. Okay, so I want to show you guys the designs. There's 5 designs in my Let's Fall in Love collection. This is the first design. It says, all I need for fall are riding boots, blanket scarves, and pumpkin spice lattes. I've got this beautiful graphic. All these graphics are 8.5 by 11. So you are going to be able to manipulate them down using the tool that I'm going to show you guys. Here is my second graphic in the collection that's Let's Fall in Love. There is a distinct Parisian theme. As you guys know, I really love, you know, like Paris, macaroons, things like that. I love fall. It's my favorite time of year. So that is kind of like the flagship image for this whole collection. The next image I have is what I call the Lex face, which is actually inspired by the Stace face from Alice and Olivia. It was actually a mug that was released with Starbucks that everyone was obsessed with. I personally own it and I love it so much. I kind of wanted to make my own version of it because this collection has a distinct sort of coffee house, like a Parisian cafe feel. So this is the next graphic in my collection. Here is a graphic number 4. This one is a very simple pumpkin spice latte graphic with some beautiful seasonal colored macaroons. It says, treat yourself. If you guys are familiar with Parks and Rec, I absolutely love that quote. So this is sort of like, you know, it's fall. It's the season of pumpkin spice lattes and sweater weather and beautiful candles from Bath & Body Works. So treat yourself. That's going to be the message of fall for me. And then the final graphic is this bow tie graphic, which again is a throwback to the original Alice and Olivia for Starbucks mug that was the striped bow tie with the gold buttons that you could buy. That was a very popular mug, which again, I own that one as well. And I know so many people love it. I was so excited to be able to turn it into a graphic so people can actually use it to actually decorate their planners. So that is my fall collection of images. Let me show you guys the journaling cards and the stickers as well. Okay, so as you can see here, this is the collection of 5 journaling cards that you get with the Let's Fall in Love set. Again, it's all of those images just kind of perfectly sized as journaling cards. And then here are the Let's Fall in Love sticker set. Again, these are my vertical square sticker set, which means that these are going to fit in those Erin Condren style vertical square boxes. Anything that's got those sort of vertical boxes, like the Me and My Big Ideas Happy Planner, Lime Life Planner, a lot of different planners use these sorts of box sizes. It's almost like a standard now. Even my own Charmed Life Planner, actually, these are equivalent for that as well. You can actually use them, although I don't have any boxes in my Charmed Planner. They do fit in my vertical layout perfectly. So again, this is the sticker set. And I actually have all of these items bundled together for you guys at a really awesome price. So definitely check out my shop if you're interested in this Let's Fall in Love fall collection. Okay, so the next collection of graphics I want to show you guys are my I Put a Spell on You Halloween collection for fall. And this collection actually has 6 different graphics, but you'll see that 2 of them are very similar. So it starts off with this beautiful Happy Halloween graphic, beautiful gray and white damask print, of course, black and white striped pumpkin, and just some fun festive Halloween font there. The second graphic is, I love this, it is a black trench coat, and this is actually a Morticia Addams quote from the original Addams Family TV show. It says, black is such a happy color, darling. And so this is my homage to Morticia Addams, absolutely love it, and it's got these adorable little skulls in the background. Very cute. Continuing on with the skull theme, I've got this graphic that says nerdy to the bone. It's a skull with glasses, of course, my signature geek glasses. The next image is I Put a Spell on You. I've got a green poison apple with this wonderful quote that, again, is the flagship quote of this I Put a Spell on You set with this wonderful black and white checker print in the background. Absolutely love it. Next, we've got a coffee cup that says, double, double, toil and trouble. I love that quote. It's a Shakespearean quote from Macbeth. So it's, you know, kind of very festive for the holiday season. You know, fall's definitely the season for coffee drinking, and so sometimes we feel like we drink so much coffee we're almost under a spell. So I thought this was very appropriate for Halloween. And then the sixth and final image is, again, very similar to the first Happy Halloween image you saw, except there's a quote here, "Something wicked this way comes," again, also from Macbeth. Another beautiful graphic that you guys can use as a cover or a divider or a dashboard, whatever you need for your planner. And of course, I've got you guys covered with the in the bundle as well. I have the journaling cards for these graphics as well. So we've got the six graphics turned into journaling cards, as well as the six graphics on a printable sticker sheet. So if you either purchase the bundle or if you purchase the stickers individually, you'll be able to download this graphic, print it out on full sheet label paper, and basically go to town decorating your planner for Halloween and the fall. So that is the last thing I wanted to show you guys for the collection today. Okay, so the final thing I wanted to show you guys in this video is this awesome free application that you can use online called Canva that will actually help you to create custom dashboards and custom dividers and covers or whatever you need for your planner. This is a wonderful, very powerful, and free online web-based graphic design app, essentially, that any of you guys can use, you can sign up for, and I'm going to show you how to use it today to take those graphics from my fall sets and actually turn them into covers or dividers or dashboards that actually will fit whatever planner you have that you want to use. So when you guys actually log in, you're going to come to almost like this intro page. And what you're going to want to do is, in order to start with this design, you know, they give you a bunch of different templates that you can start with, like social media templates, posters, Facebook covers, Facebook posts, things like that. But what we're going to do is we're going to use the custom dimensions option, okay? Because we have something a little bit different depending on what our planner is. So the first thing you're going to want to do is come over here where it says PX, that stands for pixels, and you're going to change that option to inches. And let's say you've got an Erin Condren, right? The Erin Condren is 7 by 9, I believe. So it is 7 inches wide and 9 inches high. Let's go ahead and hit design. So now it brings us to a new screen where we actually have a canvas here that is the right proportions for what we're looking for. The next thing you're going to want to do is go over here to the sidebar and hit uploads, because you're going to want to upload your own images. So I'm going to go ahead and just pull one of these graphics for now. I'm going to take that hood graphic. And what it's going to do is it's going to upload it, and you're going to see it over here. What you're going to do is literally take it and drop it in here. And then what you're going to be able to do is actually kind of just stretch it out as you want it to fit in to that size. So you see it just kind of fitted in there for you, okay? Then what you can do when you're done is hit this download button. What you're gonna wanna do is choose this image, high quality PNG. What's gonna happen, you click that button and it's gonna prepare your design, and it's actually going to export it and save it to your downloads. So as you can see, it just went in my downloads, and then voila, there is that image that is perfectly sized for an Erin Condren cover that I could then use and actually upload this design to Erin Condren, right? Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys one more of these. I'm gonna go all the way back out and show you guys. We're gonna do another custom dimension here. Again, I'm gonna change this to inches, and what we're gonna do is the personal size file of facts, right? So personal file of facts is 3.7 inches by 6.7 inches. And just to note, you guys, when you download my actual files from my site, I'm actually gonna give you guys a cheat sheet of all the popular planner covers and dimensions so that you guys know exactly what you need for your planners, okay? So again, it's taken us to this canvas that is the exact right proportion for what we want. Let's go ahead and upload another image just for fun. Let's go ahead and upload something out of my fall collection real quick. Let's do, let's do this fall essentials one. I love this. Love this graphic. So it is uploading that file for me. And it's ready now. So I can actually just take this and drop it in. So what I can do here is I can go ahead and stretch this and reposition it so that it fits in to the actual area of the screen, which is really awesome. The next thing I want to show you guys is how you can kind of just go ahead and add text to these pictures. So let's say you wanted to make a dashboard, a custom dashboard for your planner, and we've done a personal size here. What we're going to go ahead and do is let's go ahead and add a heading. So we're going to actually do this as though we wanted to put our name in there. So I'm going to go ahead and put Miss Trenchcoat, right? And as you can see, this is a little bit big and I don't necessarily like this font. Ooh, look at this pretty font, Allura. That's a pretty font. That's a nice one. And I'm going to actually just shrink this down. And I want to change this, you guys. Let's change this to some sort of custom color. Let's add a color here, which is great. You can actually go ahead in here and add a custom color code if you happen to know the hex code. But I'm just going to like eyeball it for like what looks like my kind of tealy color, because I don't have that with me on there right now. That looks about right. That looks good enough. And look, you guys, I've personalized this. Right? And I could go ahead and add a subheading as well if I wanted to, like another thing. I could say 2015 if I wanted to, right? And I could put it off to the side here. I could move it all the way up. Do you see there's a lot of things you can do here? You could change this. I could change this header to say to do, right? I can go in and change this font to something. Oh, look at this one. That one looks kind of cool. It's a cool font. Okay, and let's make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, awesome. And I could actually bring this up here. And I love how it's got the guides to actually help you. And I'm just going to go ahead and delete that one. Very easy to use this. You see, I could actually pull this down if I wanted to give the to-do more space. And it actually has those guides that help you align things. And again, if I wanted to download this, I could hit the download button. Something I want to make clear with you guys as well is if you guys are using images and they're not your original designs, for example, let's say you do go and purchase like one of my sets or one of my images that you would like to use to turn into a cover, you want to make sure that you do not select this make public button, okay? Because that would be, unless you have 100% rights to distribute an image, that would be kind of violating the copyright for an image. And as an example, the images that you would actually be downloading from my shop, you guys have the right to use it for personal use, but you don't have the right to make it public. So make sure you do not click that button, but go ahead and hit download, and you want to do that high quality PNG again. And again, it is creating the image for me, which is really awesome. It downloads it, and then all of a sudden it pops up on my screen. So this is basically how you can customize your own images for covers, divider designs, dashboards, whatever you want to do, you can use Canva. It's a wonderful free app. And the great thing about Canva is that it's not just free. You can buy upgrades. They do sell like upgrades. As you can see here in these headings, there's a lot of free headers. But if we scrolled through long enough, I'm sure we'd see here, we've got images and things like that that they'll actually let you use. You just have to download the elements. And I think they all cost like about a dollar. So like these images all cost a dollar. So these are just, you know, this is a really powerful tool, very simple to use, very user-friendly. So definitely check out Canva. Again, it's free to just use it. And you only have to pay for upgrades if you so choose. Okay, so wasn't that simple? I hope that this tutorial has helped you guys get a really good sense of how you can actually create your own custom covers for a variety of different planners, or create your own custom dashboards or custom divider images that you can then go ahead, turn around and print and actually DIY into your own planner. So definitely check out Canva. I really would highly recommend it. It is a wonderful app. And like I said, doesn't hurt to sign up. It is free and very easy to use. If you have any questions about this tutorial, let me know about it in the comments section, and I will of course help you to the best of my ability. If you liked this video, if you like seeing these sort of screencast tutorials from me, give this video a thumbs up, and of course share it on your social media as well so that your other planner friends will be able to make their own custom covers as well. So share this in your groups for Erin Condren and Kiki K and Filofax and Happy Planners and all those wonderful planners, because there are so many planners out there, you guys, and this tutorial actually applies to so many different planners. So whatever planner you use, I hope you're able to use this tutorial to help you create a custom cover or divider or dashboard for you, for your seasonal needs, or all year round, whatever you need for your planner. And of course, last but not least, if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos by me. And until next time, you guys, bye-bye.